Hello and welcome to Island Reaction. Today we're going to do a product unpackaging review of a portable ice chest. The brand I'm not familiar with, Usranvik. A-U-S-R-A-N-V-I-K, Usranvik. And this is a portable 37 quart. Put these details right there. As you can see, the amperage. This can run off of a solar panel, actually hooked up to a deep charge battery. You could run this 37 quart cooler slash freezer, or you could just lower your temperature down to make it a all refrigerator and not just freezer and refrigerator. But we're going to let our Island Reaction product review expert, Dennis, let's tell us about this.
Now the Sixers are feeling the ripple effects. Stan Coombs, the outside of the team. Oh, yes, we live in Arizona, and I keep an ice chest down here because it gets very hot. And then this is the one I've been using, but I got kind of tired of it. You know, I got to come out, and in the summertime, I got to put a block of ice in here every day. But in the wintertime, every other day. So I thought, you know, I saw these new coolers that have a compressor in them. I thought, wow, you know, that's like a refrigerator. So I ordered this one that's a little bit bigger. And that way, and I noticed it was a freezer and refrigerator, or you can make it all a refrigerator. And I was real impressed with the design and stuff. One thing I like, I thought was a good idea, is they did, they put these handles on with it. Even the UPS guy, when he was walking up, they took extra care because refrigerators are supposed to keep them upright. And so instead of tossing it, you know, they thought, well, I can carry it, you know. Made it just one more feature to, you know, ensure, you know, because it's a refrigerator, you know. And so be upright when you get them. I was impressed with that. It was packed real good. And you have to put the handles on, which is real easy. There's a bag with some screws in. And they include this little Allen wrench. They just put the handles on. It takes about 10 minutes, 5 minutes.
Now, this is a 37 quart.
Yes.
And this is the control panel there, I guess.
It gets cold real fast when you put it on max. Right now, it's it goes down to like 4 degrees. It's almost at 4 degrees. And I guess you can reset the modes here. You got to push this and hold it to unlock it. You'll see that a bit. See, it gets brighter. It's at 5 degrees in there. And that took 15 minutes to get to. So it gets cold very fast.
Nice handles.
And the thing I like, it's got a light. That really sold me on there. Cause
oh, yeah, nighttime, opening it up, see what you got inside.
So you got a big freezer and a...
Now, this is 37 quart?
Yeah. But my neighbor knows I always like these little short cans. Well, they've been in there real nice. Or you could put the bigger cans, but... It'll hold more of these. Because these stay cold. We get down to 115 degrees out here in Arizona. So these stay colder longer because they're smaller. And you can make it all a freezer. Or you can make it all a refrigerator if you just raise it up to about 40 degrees.
Now, you say this has a compressor.
Yeah, like a refrigerator. Another neat feature, it doesn't. The lid doesn't slam. You can close like that. See it. It has a little shock. I'll tell you just how warm it'll get this weekend and
whether we can expect another system. So your compressor's where?
Right down in here. But it's just like a compressor, just like a refrigerator, black, you know, style. I guess Freon is. And it only draws about on max 60
you
watts.
Look like
and
a girl.
And on ego mode, 45 watts, which is really nice.
So you
my
look
goal
like
is to get a solar panel and a 100 amp hour battery and see if I can just run this off of that.
We're ready to put 20 years of experience learning to work for you.
But,
are you ready to get back to learning?
I'm going to get a 100 amp hour battery and then put a solar panel back there and a controller and see if I can just run it off the solar and battery. Which I should be able to. It's only 45. Ego mode's only 45.
That's exactly what I would say.
But then you get into the 115 degree temperature. So we'll see. But so far, I like the idea.
Now, is that pretty easy to pick up?
Yeah, it's not that
it's
heavy.
It's a tough environment.
It's not a real heavy.
There is some.
Yeah.
There is always one individual.
And there's a whole line of these on, I got this on Amazon. So there's a whole line. You can get them as small as 10 quart, which is about this big. And it has a compressor in. That must be a small compressor.
Now, so if you have this in your vehicle, in the back of your SUV, you could just plug it into the cigarette lighter?
Yeah, uh-huh.
And it'll just run like that all the time.
Yeah, and when you shut the car off, it says it stays cold because, if you got it maxed down to -4.
So it would stay cold if you're,
yeah. You
know, turning the car on and off, it would stay cold. And how fast do you say it starts getting cold really quick as soon as it gets
up? -4 in 15 minutes.
In 15 minutes.
Yeah.
So even if it was off for a while and it stayed cold, you start the car back up in 15 minutes. You're back super cold again.
Yeah.
So that's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm planning on getting another one. I really like the idea of putting compressors in coolers. Because the compressor, you know, those ones that, I guess they call them, they're 12 volt, but their absorption, I think they're called absorption. They don't really cut it. But these things here are going to do it real, and they're priced pretty reasonable.
What's a ballpark on this item here?
I think you get it for $250. The going price is $299 or $300, but they mark it down. So if you see it marked down, jump on it. Because I made the mistake. I saw $250. I said, "Ooh, boy!" I think I'll buy that Monday. And sure enough, they marked it up. I thought, "Oh, no, $279." So I jumped on it at $279 the very next day.
Now, was this an Amazon purchase?
Yeah.
Okay.
So the very next day, they dropped it all the way down to $237.
So overall, so far, you're pretty happy with this purchase.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's worth the $300.
And you want to demonstrate the lid, how does it slam shut and jar your components?
Oh, it's got a USB port here for charging up your phone. That's for campers and stuff.
Awesome. Gotta love that.
Yeah. And then, but the light is a big plus. Because I come out at night, especially in the summertime, you know. And then, but the lid's got like a little thing that keeps it from slamming.
Yeah.
So, which is kind of neat.
And what is this mode for right there, mode button?
Oh, max or ego mode.
Oh, okay.
Ego's where it's only drawing about 45 watts. And then you could change it from Celsius if you're over in Europe. And then Fahrenheit. But yeah, it's a... I'm very pleased with it. Like I say, there's a whole line of them, different brands, and they've got compressors. They got the compressor in there. You're going to have a pretty sweet cooler.
So no need for rock salt on this one.
Yeah.
Well, all right.
Because I keep this out here all the time, and I'd make a block of ice in my refrigerator, you know, and I'd bring it out. Every day you have to, in the summertime especially, it's 115 degrees out here, you have to keep putting a block of ice in there. Of course, we'll see how much this thing works in 115 degrees, too. Because,
true.
Yeah.
Well, we might check back in with you then in the middle of summer and see. Give us a new review.
This refrigerator over here.
Fully tested. All right. Well, that's our product review there with our expert, Dennis. Thanks, Dennis. You guys click and subscribe. Come on back and see some more new videos on Island Reaction. We'll see you next time.